Dear students, I am Shiv Kumar S. Ladde, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmacology, Shulingeshwar College of Pharmacy, Almala. Today we discuss regarding genotoxicity, carcinogenicity, teratogenicity, and mutagenicity. The learning outcomes: upon the completion of this video, students should be able to identify genotoxic, mutagenic, carcinogenic, and teratogenic effect of drugs or chemicals. Also describe concept of genotoxicity, mutagenicity, carcinogenicity, and teratogenicity studies. So genotoxicity and mutagenicity, so these are the interchangeable words, because so the both the cases, the drugs are chemical, they can alter the normal physiology of the genes, but the mechanism was different. So due to these reasons, so those effects can categorized as a genotoxicity and mutagenicity. So genotoxicity studies include the study of the drugs or chemicals under the development, so their effects on the genes. So genotoxicity means the drugs or chemicals, they create toxicity on genetic materials, and those substances involved in the cause of the genotoxicity, such substances are known as the genotoxins. And due to toxicity on the genetic material, so these causes the mutations or tumors. And regarding the mutagenicity studies, it includes the study of the drugs or chemicals under the development, their mutation effects on the genes. And mutagenicity means the drugs or chemicals which impair the permanent transmissible change in DNA. Such effects by drug was known as a mutagenicity. Then those agents or drugs cause mutagenicity, so they are known as a mutagens. And mutagens, they can change the DNA and responsible to cause of the chronic diseases or disorders. So dear students, the genotoxicity due to drugs or chemicals, it can be reversed by administrations of the nutraceuticals, phytoconstituents, or to change of the lifestyle of the body. But the case of the mutagenicity, it cannot be reversed, because where the permanent irreversible damage of DNA is occurs. So now we can discuss regarding the differentiations between the genotoxicity and mutagenicity. Regarding definitions, genotoxicity is the phenomena which describe the ability of an agent or substance to destruct the genetic information of a cell. Regarding mutagenicity, the mutagenicity is the property of an agent or chemicals to cause genetic mutations. So name of the agents it is involved in the genotoxicity is known as genotoxins, while the agents it involved in the mutagenicity is called a mutagens. Then relationship between the mutagens and genotoxicity is, so all the genotoxins are not a mutagens, but all mutagens are a genotoxins. Regarding effects, so genotoxins, they can bring the destructive effect on the genetic material of the cell, causes the loss of its integrity, and due to loss of integrity, the cancer, mutation, and the birth defects can be occurs. Then mutagens, they can bring about mutations in DNA and genes, leading to primarily genetic diseases and chronic disorders. So here are certain agents which can cause the genotoxicity by damaging the DNA are reactive oxygen species. So some drugs are chemicals, so they act as the free radicals, or they having the capability to produce the free radicals, and these free radicals, so they can cause the genotoxicity and mutations on the genes. UV and ionizing radiations, so these are also involved in the cause of genotoxicity. Nucleoside analogs, So these are alter the formations of purine 500 bases, the DNA sequence and RNA sequence. Due to that, they produce the mutations and genotoxicity. And topoisomerase inhibitors like fluoroquinolones, so they can cause the genotoxicity and mutation. So due to this reason, the gatifloxacin was banned from the market. Protein synthesis inhibitors like chloramphenicol, tetracycline, macrolides and aminoglycoside antibiotic, they can cause the mutations in the DNA. So due to mutations by these drugs, the resistance can be developed. The standard tests for genotoxicity are AIM test. In the AIM test, the testing drugs are substance, so they are incubated with the bacteria like Salmonella typhi and E. coli in agar media at a temperature 37 degrees centigrade and for 2 to 3 days. So after 3 days, so note down the formations of colony. So as the formations of colony is increases as compared to control group, it indicates so that incubated drugs and chemical, it can causes the genotoxicity. And second test, in vitro mammalian cell micronucleus test. So these micronucleus cells, so they only observe so where the chromosomes are mutated or causes the genotoxicity in the chromosomes. So the drugs, so they are incubated with the mammalian cells, and after 24 hours note down or to count the presence of the micronucleus. If the percentage was increases, it indicates that incubated drug was caused the genotoxicity. And third test, mammalian bone marrow chromosomes abbreviation test. So here the mammalian bone cells or stem cells, they are incubated with the drugs and chemicals under the study. So then finally they note down the mitotic index. If the mitotic index was increases, it indicates the chromosomes are mutated, because so after the chromosomes mutations only the mitotic spindles, so they still remain in the cultures. Then carcinogenicity studies is include to find out the ability or tendency of a chemical to induce a tumors, and also note down the development of neoplastic lesions during the or after exposure to various doses of test substance by an appropriate route of administration. So in carcinogenicity study, the rats and mice are used, and the drug was administered by the oral route, and each group should be consist of 50 animals. Then 3 doses should be selected from the testing substance, and along with 1 control group should be used. The durations of the carcinogenicity study was 18 to 24 months, and the study was terminated by when the control group animals falls below 25% or to note down the number of survivors in the lower dose group. Teratogenicity. So teratogenicity include the study of the drugs or chemicals on a fetus. So these teratogenic drugs, so they can affect on the fetus at different 3 stages. The first was fertilization implantation. The duration was conception to 17 days. If the drug shows teratogenicity, means it can cause the terminations of pregnancy. Then second, organogenesis. The period is 18 to 55 days of gestations. If the drug was teratogenic, means it can cause the abnormal development of the organs on the fetus. Then growth and development, it is after 56 days onwards of the gestations. So if the drug was teratogenicity, means it can cause the abnormalities in the functions of the systems or organs. Then mechanism of teratogenic drugs, so they are having the capability to inhibit the folate methylation cycles. Examples was anti-cancer agents. So due to use of anti-cancer drugs during the pregnancy, the after the labor, the baby or infant, they are suffering from the various kind of the anemias, because so these drugs, they alter the folate metabolisms. Then use of oral contraceptives during the pregnancy, so they can cause the teratogenicity by inhibiting the release of sex hormones, especially in the male candidates. Then some drugs like acetazolamide, topiramide, they cause the reductions in the embryonic intracellular pH. So due to that, they can produce the acidosis. So due to acidosis, by use of these drugs during the pregnancy, so that womb or infant will be suffering from the various chronic disorders like cancers, diabetes mellitus, or many other disorders. So dear students, so this is the message regarding the public health awareness forum for corona preventions. Thank you.